The Celtic harp is an ancient instrument. Images of harps appear on Pictish stone carvings from about 200 AD and on ancient jewelry and ornaments. Also, harps are found in the rich heritage of myths and stories of the Celts. The size and shape of the harp may vary slightly, but all have a triangular shape with a soundbox and curved four-pillar. The oldest instruments had wire strings and were played with the fingernails. The harper was held in great esteem in the life of the old clans. There are records of payments being made to the clan harper in the form of clothing, land, animals, and favors. The harper often told the history of the clan in his music and would sing about the history by the fireside, noting important births, deaths, victories, and defeats through songs and tunes. The earliest surviving harps from Scotland and Ireland date to about the 15th century. For centuries, the harp was an integral part of Irish life. Traveling harpists in Ireland were known to be at the focal point of rebellions, so much so that the harp was banned. The period starting from the 1600s during English rule in Ireland was difficult for Irish harpers as the harp, as a folk and court instrument, was suppressed to prevent a resurgence of nationalism. Harps were burnt and harpers executed. The tragic extinction of this harping tradition at the end of the 18th century had a number of causes. First, the Anglicization of Irish cultures. Second, the increased popularity of step dancing and the fiddle. And third, the inability of the harp to play the musical accidentals required for classical music. Only in Wales was the folk harping tradition unbroken. By the late 18th century, it was clear that Irish harpers were nearly extinct. Because harp music had always been handed down orally, very little of it has been preserved. The most important attempt to save the music was made in 1792. In order to encourage and preserve the old harping tradition, a festival was held in Belfast and newspaper advertisements invited all Irish harpers to come and play for cash prizes. Only 10 harpers, ranging in age from 15 to 97, could be found. A 19-year-old church organist named Edward Bunting was hired to notate the music, but with few exceptions, only the melodies and not the bass lines were taken down. Bunting had so much enthusiasm during the festival that he continued to collect traditional tunes throughout his life, publishing three collections in 1797, 1809, and 1840. Bunting collected not only the music, but much lore and technical information from the harpers. All of the surviving O'Carolan melodies date to these works. The excerpt that follows is a part of O'Carolan's dream piece. Survive, and this proves to be a historic oversight. Now we know little about how the harp was originally played. There has been a slow revival of Celtic harp melodies, techniques, and popularity since the 1930s, which has exploded since 1970. Many harpers have also assisted in the recovery of the lost Celtic harping tradition. The resurgence in the late 20th century of the North American traveling troubadour harpers like Sylvia Woods and Derek Bell have led to a resurgence of folk harping throughout Ireland and in the rest of the Western world. Today, the Irish or Celtic folk lover harp is again an important part of Irish and world culture.